Dear students, today's topic is Gauss theorem. Gauss theorem states the relation between flux passed through any closed surface and charge enclosed by that surface. As per statement of this theorem, electric flux passed through any surface is 1 upon epsilon naught times of charge enclosed by the surface. Suppose this is a charge and this is a surface, and we consider that there is a small surface of ds, and solid angle sustained by this small surface we can represent it by d omega, and direction of electric field due to this charged particle, this is the direction of electric field, and it is the direction of unit vector. And this angle is theta. Now we want to prove this Gauss theorem. We know that flux is, suppose d phi e is the flux due to this small surface. D phi e flux passed through this small surface. D phi e should be equal to electric field dot ds, dot product of small surface and electric field, or we can write E ds cos theta. This is d phi e, and we know that electric field is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square if this distance is r. Electric field at this point, at that point, due to this charged particle, that should be equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square ds cos theta. Now we want to determine electric flux, total electric flux. It should be integration of d phi e and integration 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square ds cos theta. We can take the constants outside from the integration. Phi e equal to q upon 4 pi epsilon naught. This is surface, so it should be surface integration ds cos theta upon r square. In our previous video, we have proved that ds cos theta upon r square is equal to solid angle, small solid angle d omega. It means this part becomes d omega, and phi e is q upon 4 pi epsilon naught surface integration d omega. And we also know that surface integration of solid angle, it should be equal to surface integration of solid angle, it should be equal to 4 pi, and it becomes phi e is equal to q upon 4 pi epsilon naught, it part becomes equal to 4 pi. 4 pi cancel out, and phi e is equal to q upon epsilon naught. It means flux passed through a surface is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught times of charge enclosed by the surface. This is proof of Gauss theorem. Now we discuss the first application of Gauss theorem, in which we derive the formula of electric field due to a point charge, or it is also a deduction of Coulomb's law. Suppose this is a charged particle and it is situated at the center of a sphere. This is a sphere. We consider that there is a small surface area, small area which having a surface area ds, and electric field due to this charged particle is in this direction. And we know that unit vector is also perpendicular to this surface. The direction of unit vector and electric field are same, or we can say that the angle between unit vector and electric field in this situation is equal to zero. And suppose the electric flux which passes through this small surface, it should be d phi e, and d phi e equal to e dot ds. or we can say phi e is integration of d phi e integration e dot ds, and it should be a surface integration, closed integration. Or we can also say that e dot ds means e ds cos theta, and in this condition theta is 0, or we can write integration e ds. E is constant, it becomes e surface integration of ds, and it should be equal to e into s. S means surface area of this sphere, and we know that surface area of this sphere should be 4 pi r square. It means this electric field should be equal to e into, sorry, this electric flux should be equal to e into 4 pi r square. And phi, as per Gauss theorem, phi e is 1 upon epsilon naught times of charge enclosed by the surface. It means we can put here, it becomes q upon epsilon naught, q upon 4 epsilon naught is equal to e into 4 pi r square. First we want to determine the electric field. E is equal to q upon epsilon naught 4 pi r square, or electric field is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught 4 pi epsilon naught q upon r square. This is the derivation of electric field due to a point charge q. Now Coulomb's law, we know that F is q naught e, force on a test charge particle. If a test charge particle q naught is available inside the electric field E, then force on this charge particle, it should be F equal to Q naught into E. And F equal to Q naught E is Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught R square, and force becomes 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q Q naught upon R square. This is force between charge Q and Q naught. And that is Coulomb's law. It means first application of Gauss theorem, we can derive the formula of electric field due to a point charge, and we can also derive Coulomb's law. Thank you.